Russia says it extinguished scores of what it called Ukrainian nationalists. Its military reported Tuesday at least 70 Ukraine-aligned fighters were killed in its operation to repel the cross-border raiders who entered the country's Belgorod region. It adds it is now pushing the remainder back into Ukraine. The governor of Belgorod also said a civilian was killed at the hands of Ukrainian armed forces. The two anti-Kremlin groups, which claim responsibility for the attack, both asserted they are comprised of armed Russian fighters seeking to overthrow Russian President Vladimir Putin. Moscow blames Kiev, which has denied any involvement in the raid. Sri Lanka's Navy locates 14 bodies inside a Chinese fishing vessel that capsized in the Indian Ocean last week. Two of the bodies have been recovered, while the locations of the 12 others have been handed to Chinese authorities. Their nationalities have not been disclosed. The discovery comes a day after a preliminary Chinese government probe concluded there were no survivors. The boat capsized May 16 with 17 Chinese, 17 Indonesians, and 5 Filipinos on board. The Philippine Coast Guard says it is coordinating with the Foreign Affairs Department on how to assist the families of the victims. Typhoon Mawar expected to pass directly over the U.S. territory of Guam, bringing potentially catastrophic winds and torrential rains to the Pacific Military Outpost. The storm is packing maximum sustained winds of 225 kilometers per hour. Local authorities have issued evacuation orders and opened temporary shelters. According to the island's governor, Mawar is the strongest storm to hit Guam in two decades. Ahead of its arrival, U.S. forces based on the island sent away ships and other major apparatus that could be damaged by the Category 4 hurricane. Storm surges reaching 20 to 25 feet are predicted near the eye wall, as well as 20 inches of rain in some areas. U.S. President Joe Biden declared a state of emergency on the island of 170,000 people, paving the way for federal aid. Ukraine is investigating Belarus's suspected involvement in the forced transfer of children from Russian-occupied territory. That's after a preliminary report revealed more than 2,000 Ukrainian children were deported to so-called recreation camps and sanatoriums in Belarus. The report noted that transfers of minors, including orphans aged 6 to 15, were in violation of the Geneva Conventions and the Rome Statute. In March, the International Criminal Court issued arrest warrants for Russian President Vladimir Putin and Moscow's Ombudsman for Children's Rights for war crimes involving the illegal deportation of Ukrainian children. Kiev has alleged that around 20,000 children from Ukraine have been forcibly transported or deported to Russia since the start of the war. A female student is suspected of starting the deadly fire at a school dormitory in Guyana that killed 19 children. Police say the student lit the fire after school authorities confiscated her phone. The victims, mostly indigenous girls, died around midnight Monday, most at the scene. Police have not mentioned an arrest, and the mayor of the town where the school is located could not confirm whether the suspect is in custody. The country's president has declared 3 days of national mourning.